This meeting of the West Bridgewater Board of Assessors.
6:04, Mr. Chairman.
6:04, and we are being taped by the West Bridgewater Community TV.
And would you like me to read the state of emergency public access?
Yes, please.
Due to the public safety concerns regarding COVID-19 pandemic, this meeting will be open to the public through remote participation only. The meeting will be accessible to the public via audio conferencing capabilities by telephone. If you would like to listen live, please dial 425-436-6392 and enter the access code number 604239 to join the live teleconference. Please be advised that the chairman may not allow questions from the listening public. To view a live broadcast of the meeting, please go to West Bridgewater TV's channel line on Comcast Cable Television. For my report, you don't have any appointments?
Yeah, okay, I see that, yeah.
For my report, again, I just give you, I send you this in the mail, so I don't know if I really need to repeat it.
No, no.
I email it to you.
Anything that stands out, you might want to, but I see it's pretty basic.
Well, things are going very well, and again, I commend Daniella. She's doing a great job working from home.
Good.
We communicate almost probably on a daily basis, and I will drop off material that she needs at her house, and then I will pick them up at a later date and process mostly mail.
Good, that sounds good.
So regarding old business and new business, I have two items before you on the agenda. One is a request to transfer Principal Secretary Daniella Nelson to the full-time position. If you recall, the town administrator and the assistant town administrator sent the board an email on May 4th, I believe, notifying you of the vacancy of the full-time position. And in that memo, they stated that if the board would like to elevate Daniella to the full-time position, all you need to do is send a letter of recommendation.
Yeah, in about 2 seconds. That's a no-brainer.
So I prepared a memorandum for your initial, and I made a copy for each of you.
I just want to add on that, when I say no-brainer, because we've had a chance to work with Daniella for, you know, over a year now, and I know I'm not here on a weekly or daily basis, but I'm talking to the other board members and you, and know what I know about the position, I think she does an excellent job. There's never any real issues that I can see. And a couple of times I've asked her to do something, and, you know, it's been done, no questions asked. So I think she's an asset for the job and should go full-time.
She's a model employee, and she does do an excellent job.
Daniella, did you hear all that?
Not a word.
Huh? Are you there?
I heard you, yes.
Yeah. What are you now, getting up off the floor, huh? No, okay, that's good, thanks.
So the memorandum states two things to the Board of Selectmen, that you're requesting that she be elevated to full-time, and also that the board requests that the vacated part-time position for Principal Assessing Secretary be advertised immediately for potential hire by July 1.
And does the human resource officer, she'll go through you regarding a posting of that job? And how we want, you know, the same as like when we hired Daniella, the, you know, what the job's about, all the requirements and such?
I believe so. The last time we filled the position, that's what we did. We worked together. Last time she, the human resources officer, director, it was a new hire, so she wasn't really familiar with procedures for West Bridgewater. So she put the burden on me to accept all the applications and call them out. I think this time around, that will be the only difference, that she'll accept it.
Yeah, I don't know if it's going to be said in that ad, probably not, but, you know, behind the lines will be a fact that down the road at some point, if any, we'll try to make it a full-time position, you know, certainly not for FY '21.
That's not going to happen this year.
No, I know that because of the different circumstances, but, you know, if the applicant asks, we can say, we're certainly going to try, you know, depending how they work out and stuff.
So I don't know if you want to put it to a vote, or if that, you want to make that the consensus of the board, but in either case, I would ask you to initial the letter, assume you're both in agreement.
Now, you want to, do we first want to write that letter to the human resource and the town manager, get their approval, you know, and I know, you know, we're going to get it, that's an automatic thing. And do the vote now, do you want to wait till they've seen our letter of, you know, engagement to get this job going.
I think you'd want to act now because...
That's fine, yeah.
There's only a month left of the fiscal year.
Right, yeah.
And so if you did it tonight, it would more than likely be on their agenda for their next meeting in 2 weeks.
All right, well, I'll make a motion that the board put in process the, to get going, the letter to the human resource officer that will potentially start the interviewing process for the part-time, what is it?
Principal assessor.
Principal assessor.
Secretary.
Principal secretary, yeah. So I'll make a motion on that.
Second?
Second. All those in favor?
Aye.
And do we need a roll call?
No, because you don't have anybody remotely participate. You don't have...
Right, okay, yeah. All right, yes, so...
200.
Yeah.
Would you just please initial that number?
Yeah.
And then the second item I have is the tax map maintenance contract for the ensuing year. For your information, I looked at this proposal, and I looked at last year's proposal, and it appears to be exactly the same as last year. There are no differences that I could discern. So the contract amount is the same, $2,500, and the terms and conditions appear to be the same.
Okay.
So I would recommend...
It's the same, I know a while back, it's the same vendor, right, obviously?
Same vendor, yeah. CAI, they also host the maps online now, as you know.
And what is, since you're the go-to guy, with the GIS stuff, what's your opinion on it? The presentation, I thought, was good,
I have known this company for about 30 years. I worked with them when I was on the Board of Assessors in the town of Wayham. They did our assessors map for a number of years. And they're very responsive, they're very competent, and they're very reasonable in their price.
All right, a question, if you know, you probably do. In the course of my business, I go into a lot of communities, and now, especially now with the COVID, and even without it, I do a lot of that stuff online regarding tax maps. And I find a lot of the communities, some communities make a conservative effort to go, in favor of the taxpayer, the appraiser, to put all those layers online. Some of them don't even show meets and bounds. They have a basic, maybe a corner or something, which it's helpful, but so the question stands that with our fee to them, does that include all the layers, or could we increase the fee to increase the layers? Not that we're going to, but are we paying almost like a prorated type for this amount? You'll get, outlined in lots and meets and bounds without a zoning overlay. Or like the city of Brock's got excellent maps now. They show everything on aerials, they outline it, but they're paying for that, so, or maybe not, maybe it's in-house. So the question is, when we pay the fee, does that include the best of the best for the online services, or just a basic, give back on the online? Once we go online with them, if I look it up as an appraiser, what I would get.
When I would compare it to the two or three other software packages that are out there for online mapping, one is People GIS, and I can't recall the name of the other one. I would say comparing them to one another, this service is as good as, or maybe slightly better.
No, that's not the question. The question is, can they hold off certain layers, overlays, on the online mapping to save money for the town? Like some of those, they go into rail lines, water lines, topo, wetlands, buffer, and some just have, like I said, I'm trying to think of one, maybe, I don't know, Avon or something. One of those, you look at it, not at the office, I'm talking to the guy online, and you get a basic mapping route and the parcel identification and, where the improvement sits. Other ones, there's 18 layers, like they're Brockton now. There's all kinds of layers, which is excellent. But I'm saying that for the online service, I know they all probably, Peoples or whatever, they all have that ability, but is there a price difference on what you offer online? Like for example, Vision Now, a lot of communities, like Wareham, I didn't know if I talked to you or you talked to your boss that, I can get the online card and I can get the actual card online. So I'm sure they're paying, maybe not paying, I'm not sure, but that's a service that I love. So the question stands on the mapping, are we on the $2,500, we're gonna show just certain, let's say there's 12 layers. They might not show all of them online to save money. No? Yes?
Well, we're talking about two things. First of all, this contract is to maintain the maps.
Okay.
To update all the changes.
Yeah, I'm sorry, yeah.
For the $3,000 online mapping, hosting.
Yeah.
You recall the presentation
yes.
that the representative yeah. from the company made. So I think my recollection, Steve, is it was probably a dozen to 15 different layers
yes.
that
yeah.
were available.
Yeah.
And I think...
Do you have a menu that for the online or price? Or?
Yeah, I don't think there's any real difference in price. I don't think they could really add anything unless it was some type of specialty product. That
not add, but subtract. Like, in other words, don't show, you know, the buffer areas or the wetlands because you have other resources for that.
Well, I think they put them there so that the user could see whatever they want to see. And I look at it from the point of view, Steve, of the Mass GIS.
No,
Mass GIS
yeah, right, exactly, yeah.
So once it gets into the public marketplace, any vendor, including CAI, can take Mass GIS data and
which is
basically what they do.
You kind of answered my question, right? When you go in the Muni Map Maker, for yeah. example, the town of Berkeley, I've done something right down there, on the Oliver system, right? The layers aren't there because that's the town has got that type of GIS that they give to the you know information to the Mass GIS.
Mass GIS,
right.
See, they don't have it. And that's my point.
Well, they have. You can't go in and get a basic, you know, right. all of a map, but it doesn't show any. You know, for example, when it's full fledged all of a map, they'll show you people sitting on a couch. It's unbelievable the stuff they have. Some towns have maybe because of their limited funds. The GIS is not that sophisticated. So that was my question
that
if you have all those layers from our vendor, can we save money by holding some of those layers offline?
I don't think so.
Okay. That's all I want to know.
I think it's really just the level of sophistication of
yeah.
the data that we have that we provide to them that they put onto their
right.
own
and
when so a smaller community with less resources has a basic map. Like you
right.
said, even if they don't have meets and bounds.
Right.
Then that's what's going to go online.
Right, 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 right. And I mean, I think that all of the thing is, you know, when it first came out, it was like trying to, you know, Albert Einstein had to use it, you know, and now it's very user-friendly, but there is a considerable difference between, like, say, you know, Berkeley and probably Newton, you know, for example. Okay, thank you.
Well, you know, Newton measured all the trees and the diameters of the trees on every sidewalk.
But they, I called out my old pal up there, you go into the office, the tax maps on the counter and online do not show meets and bounds. And I was working with those maps when I worked up there 25 years ago. So that totally most sophisticated community in the world, them in Cambridge, right? Mm-hmm. For some reason, they don't have a layer. That's what they told me, and I talked to the head honcho, okay. showing meets and bounds, which is, you know, that's the basic thing you want is, you know, the frontage, you know.
Which probably has something to do when the maps were originally developed.
Yeah, but this they had maps out, you know, when, you know, whatever.
I mean, they might have had the original maps from the 1600s, but 1700s.
Oh, no, they had, when I left there, they were state of the art. But,
I know they have some sophisticated layers.
Yeah.
I'm just talking about the base layer.
I was slammed with that.
Which is the Assessors.
Yeah. The fourth highest value community in the Commonwealth, and you know, at the time I was there 3 years ago, they didn't show meets and bounds. Okay. I've ranted and raved enough. Move on. Sorry.
So my recommendation is that you sign this, you approve this evening. Do I make a motion, or if it's a consensus of the board?
Well, I have a question here. When does this contract begin and end?
It begins when you sign it, and it ends when they complete it. And
all right, because it says this is a contract made this 11th day of February 2019.
Right, you're right. And I looked at last year's, which is dated April 2nd. And guess what the start date was?
2017?
11th day of February 2019, so I think that's just standard language.
The contract comes from them.
Yeah.
But how can we, then this says it's a contract that we started it February 11th of 2019?
Well, it says a contract is made, which could also mean started. And clearly,
commensurated, yeah.
I can change that to today's date.
That's fine, yeah.
Which is the date that you signed with.
Okay.
Yes. June.
Well, shouldn't they make that change?
2020. Well, yeah. If you want to sign it later, you can sign it out. I just changed it.
And let them know about that, yeah.
You can initial it.
Okay. And that begins, it really, it's with FY '21?
Because obviously, I picked up on that too, because obviously it didn't start over a year ago.
Well, right, but you would think that that would have been corrected, or that just doesn't seem to make a whole lot of sense.
I agree.
And it sounds to me like a, hopefully just a formality.
They have, it's clear to me they have a standing contract, because like I said, it's identical in every aspect to last year's contract.
Yeah.
So I think that's not only an issue with this community, the town of West Bridgewater, but every community, I think they put that out.
Yeah.
And somebody needs to have it brought to their attention.
That would be you.
Yeah, because I don't feel comfortable signing it like that.
Well, what would you like to do? Would you like me to call them and tell them I made the change and that you'll sign it as soon as they agree that that change has been made?
Well, I just think it needs to be clear, because that looks to me as if it's saying that's when the contract begins. There should be something, unless there's another line in here that I'm just not seeing, because we just got this right before the meeting.
I would say, you know, maybe initial it, and if they play hardball with it, which they won't, then you won't submit it.
That's an option that I think is reasonable, because you also date it the day you sign it, which is today.
Yeah. And it's effective when, today or FY 21?
That's it.
Yeah. And it just continues on.
I mean, you know what they do, you know what all the companies do. Sign a maintenance agreement, they update the mats, and we do it all over again.
Right.
Yeah. Do you want to see if I can get Cheryl on the phone? Daniella,
does it have to be done today, then? Can it be done the next meeting?
Well, I'd like to get them done this time. Because again, we're getting to the end of the fiscal year.
Yeah.
So conceivably, they could get them done in a month.
On your thing there, is that the correct date for our next meeting? It's a week short.
On the agenda?
Yeah.
2 weeks from today. 3 and 4 is 17, right?
Yeah. Yeah. I think it's
in the 17th. You catch.
Maybe that was written in 1998 too, or it was.
Daniella, are you capable of calling Cheryl and including her in this meeting? Can you teleconference on your phone?
Well, she said she wasn't, otherwise she would have said call her. She's probably not available, right?
She told me she had a migraine. Maybe she would give us 2 minutes.
That's kind of intrusive, though, if she said she's not feeling well.
But he wants to get that done.
Well, no, I understand that, but I mean, if you talk to Cheryl tomorrow and she chooses to sign it, that's up to you guys, but I just think it's kind of intrusive.
As long as you're willing to do it by consensus. By consensus of the board.
That's fine, yeah. I just want to get it done. Let's move on here.
Okay.
You know, it's no biggie. The date's an oversight on their part. It's not going to be any dough out of the town's part. It's going to get done. Let's get it done.
Okay, never mind, Daniella. Thank you.
Okay.
Thank you. So, I don't have any bills payable or warrants.
Uh-huh.
Your signature. So, and I don't have any minutes, although I've reviewed the minutes of the last couple of meetings, and I will present them at your next meeting.
You don't have any warrants that I can sign in correctly again, huh? Twice.
But I do have one item for executive session.
Okay.
So, motion would be right to enter executive session and not to return to open session.
Okay.
For the purposes of reviewing application for abatement, relative to purpose 7 of Mass General Laws, Chapter 59, Section 60. And I don't have any appellate tax court cases to discuss with you, and I don't have
That's
any
good.
Executive session. So that would be the only reason to go into executive session.
Good. Okay, yeah. We all set for that? I'll make a motion that the board enters into executive session for the reasons that Principal Assessor Donahue just mentioned. Do I hear a second?
Second.
Okay, I need a roll call. Is it a roll call vote? I need a roll call vote, please. Assessor Bunker?
Yep.
McCarthy? Yeah. And we won't, you mentioned we won't.
6:24.
Good.
Okay.